Cole, Mr. Sola, and Mrs. Kerr again for your morning announcements. It is Thursday, March 18th. It is a day two on your schedule. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, boys and girls, you may take your seats. And we're going to send it over for the weather report.
Thanks, Ms. Kerr, Mr. Sola. That was fantastic. Hey, CE Cole, welcome to a cloudy Thursday. And there's going to be a lot of rain in store for us in the next 24 hours. Probably about a half an inch of rain today, and then another half inch of rain coming tonight. And it's just going to be a cloudy, miserable day. High is going to be around 52 degrees, and then tonight is going to be around 37 degrees. Now, our question of the day comes from two students, Rodrigo Marino and Madison Crater, who ask about what a red flag warning is and how wildfires can spread. Okay, so we had a red flag warning for most of our weekend, even into the early week. And what that means is that the conditions in our atmosphere could spark a wildfire if you don't be careful, meaning like campfires, barbecues, heavy machinery like lawnmowers. Now the conditions for this in our atmosphere have to do with a few things. One is humidity level. If the humidity level falls below 15%, and that really has to do with the moisture in the air, that falls below 15%, and we have surface winds that continue around 25 miles per hour, and we had dry conditions leading up to it, then that could issue a red flag warning. And we actually had a wildfire occur in Lakewood, New Jersey, and really spread extremely fast and burned a lot of acres of ground in Lakewood, New Jersey, because of the conditions. And the wind just kept on gusting and the fire continued to spread. And last week we talked a little bit about forest fires and how certain ecosystems do very well after a fire, but other ones, it can be very hazardous and it can be very detrimental for the people that live in that area. So that's something that firefighters really had to battle with in Lakewood, New Jersey. Okay, that was a great question and a very appropriate question considering this past weekend. Thanks guys for that one. All right, Mr. Sola, Mrs. Kerr, back to you.
Thank you for that, Mr. Payne. Today, I am going to talk about idioms again, and they're related to food. So, remember, idioms are phrases where the words don't mean exactly what they say. So, if someone says you're going to butter somebody up, that doesn't mean they're slathering you with butter. It means they're paying you lots of compliments to try and get something from you. They want to flatter you and then maybe get something in return. If someone tells you not to cry over spilled milk, they're not telling you to actually stop crying because you spilled physical milk. They're telling you that it's done, it's over, and you need to move on from it. Stop get fussing about something that you can't change anymore. And then likewise, if someone tells you, I have bigger fish to fry, they're telling you that they don't mean they're going to put a bigger fish in the pan to cook. They're actually telling you that they have more important things to take care of and they have to move on and take care of that. So those are three food-related idioms that you'll hear a lot.
So if you're saying that if you have bigger fish to fry, that means everything else is small potatoes?
Maybe.
Okay. All right, boys and girls.
But
oh,
before
go
you go
Sorry.
On, Mr. Sola, I do want to remind you that we are still reading chapters from the One School, One Book, Save Me a Seat. And today we'll be listening to chapters 13 and 14. And the book is a great book, but if you don't have a copy, we still have copies here at CE Cole. You can pick them up at the school between 8 and 4 when the office is open.
Awesome. Thank you, Mrs. Kerr. I hope you, first of all, I hope you guys all had a great St. Patrick's Day yesterday. Today, being March 18th, it's known as Awkward Moments Day. Now, it's pretty funny because I have plenty of awkward moments, and I talk with some teachers all the time about my awkward moments. Mr. Coldren and I always chatting about funny, awkward moments. So if you have an awkward moment, embrace it. It's okay. It's not going to end your day. Just whatever. Laugh it off and keep on moving. Okay? A few things that I wanted to talk about before we end this is be mindful of the adjustment to our schedules, boys and girls. Yesterday and today was completely different than how you've been doing it for the last 120 plus days, right? So be mindful of it. Get to your meetings by 9:15, no later. Be in your homeroom at 9 o'clock. Talk to your teachers if you're not sure exactly what to do. If you're not sure of your schedule, please check your Google Classroom. Please ask your teachers. Okay, things are getting very exciting, to say the least. Hard to believe that it's been over a year since students walked these halls. Okay, but we're getting there, and next week it starts up. So make sure that, you know, you're getting your minds right, and you're following your teacher's instructions, getting to the meetings you need to be, and starting to get prepared to come back here at school.
Some of you will be coming back next week,
yes.
And some will be coming back the week after spring break.
Absolutely. So it's getting there. We're rapidly approaching the end of the third quarter. It's almost the fourth quarter. So, boys and girls, school's getting as real as it's going to be. We're coming back. So get ready for it. Have a wonderful day. Follow your teacher's instructions and get to where you need to be. Have a good one.